What up, agents? Prime here. Another TU-11 build handling the backfire up to 320% critical hit damage. Are you ready? Let's go! What up, guys? Welcome to another Division 2 video. Thanks for clicking my content. Really appreciate you watching it. And another build, guys. Yes, the backfire build. And I'm gonna do it a little bit different. I'm gonna start with the build first. And then I'm gonna show you some gameplay and talking about the whole setup. And of course, this new SMG, the backfire. So let's start with that backfire. 101.9k base damage, an RPM of 850 and a mag of 54. I got it on 14.8% SMG, 20.5% critical hit chance, and 9% magazine size. And it's all about payment in kind, guys. Dealing damage to enemies adds a stack of 1% critical hit damage up to 200, lasting for 10 seconds. So that means if you add that stack to that 200, you will have 200% critical hit damage upon the critical hit damage you already have. And that's why this build has such a high critical hit damage output. And then on reload applies a 10 seconds bleed to yourself, which deals 0.5% armor per stack. But of course, we're utilizing that with some hazard protection. Over to the rest of the build, I'm using the Vector as my secondary killer on there, fire rate. But I'm not really using this gun. This is mainly to switch over if I really have to, but never do, to be honest. And just like with my shotgun, the same, you know, just using this for the preservation, or maybe switch over to my handgun for that in sync, but rarely use it. Then I got the firewall specialization. Why? Because if we are close, because in my opinion you need to be close with an SMG or a little bit closer, and then you want to rock that intimidate and bull rush. That's my opinion how to do the best damage output. There are a lot of builds in TU-11 that will handle adrenaline rush and intimidate, or maybe intimidate and even the memento backpack. That's a big boost for quite a different build, but I'm coming with some different builds with the memento backpack as well. So let's go further with that firewall specialization, of course doing it for my shield. That shield, the firewall specialization shield, will give you some damage per enemy in front of your shield, and of course keeps yourself alive, because I went with 3 reds and 3 blues. Because there's no armor on kill, or there's no extra incoming armor, no armor regeneration. So in my opinion, I needed to go for that 3-piece blue up on that 1.2, 1.3 million. And then of course went for some armor on kill still. So I still have a little bit of armor on kill to keep myself alive. But over to the setup. 2 pieces of Cheska, 1 piece of Sokolov, 1 piece of Grupo, 1 piece of Yal for the hazard protection, of course, and the 511 named. Let's start with the 511 named. This will give me that 10% armor on kill. Why? Because I think this will help your survivability a lot. With the 3 blues, your shield will hold on quite a while, but still on the higher difficulties, on the heroic or even on the legendary, it gets shredded quite fast, and you need that armor on kill to keep yourself alive as well. So that's why I went for this 511. That health isn't doing nothing for me, but I'm doing it for that armor on kill, and of course then that 12% critical hit damage. Over to the 2-piece Cheska. Why the 2-piece Cheska? Of course, to critical hit chance, and the 2nd piece will give us hazard protection. 12.1% weapon damage, 9.8% hazard protection, 11% critical hit damage, and 9.7% bleed resistance as a mod, and then intimidate. Of course, amplifying our weapon damage at 35% to enemies within 10 meters. 2nd piece of Cheska, knee pads, weapon damage maxed out, critical hit chance maxed out, and almost hazard protection maxed out. This is a very, very nice role to have, and to combine these over to the second piece that will give me hazard protection as a brand set. It's the Yarl. Almost 140k armor, 11.5% critical hit damage, and I rolled at 10% hazard protection on there. And then over to my mask from Grupo. Why Grupo? Because that gives me some extra critical hit damage. I rolled the armor core over that weapon damage and got critical hit damage and hazard protection on there and went for bleed resistance as a mod. Backpack from Sokolov. Why Sokolov? Some SMG damage, of course, boosting up the backfire. Because the backfire crit hits, so the one that you stack, go off of your weapon damage. So it doesn't do much if you push up that critical hit damage even higher and lose that Sokolov. No, the Sokolov is the best choice for your damage with the backfire on your build. It's maxed out. I rolled that adrenaline rush on there. I would love to see some other things that headshot damage on there, of course. Some critical hit damage should be nice. Or maybe some hazard protection so I can get up to that 12% mod. Because if you can roll it hazard protection on your build, do it. Because there is some critical hit chance or critical hit damage that can get up to that 12%. Or even that 15% if you go for a brand set. So not always choose for the brand sets that only give you 10% hazard protection. It's better to roll it on your gear and then go for a brand set that gives you that 15% critical hit damage. It's 3% more than you can roll and 5% more on the total percentage against that hazard protection. So that's pretty much the setup of the build. Of course, just like I explained, I went for my striker shield having 11% damage per enemy in front of that shield. So if an enemy is in front of there or multiple enemies in front of there, you will get 11% per enemy. 5 enemies in front of you or in that buff angle of 45%, you will get 55% extra damage bonus. And that's quite a lot, guys. Quite a lot. Helps you out and, of course, helps out the survivability of this build as well. I use the poles because I would love to know where they're coming from or where they are hiding. You are running around and, of course, the backfire, the payment in kind, only lasts for 10 seconds. So if you are searching for your enemy in, for example, a big space, you're losing those seconds and you're losing then, of course, the proc from payment in kind. Then over to the stats. The base stats are 101k weapon damage, almost at 102k. Then we got a almost maxed out crit chance, 57.5%, and then 109.2%. And that's why this goes up to that 309.2%. So almost 310% critical hit damage if you're fully stacked with that payment in kind, with the backfire. Then I got some headshot damage, not really worth it. Over to the defensive, almost 1.2 million armor, 120k armor on kill, no armor regeneration, of course. And then, of course, the most important part is the 97.5% bleed resistance. This is needed, of course, to stop the reload on the backfire. And this is one of the things that could be nice with this build, but in my opinion, you need to utilize too much of a hazard protection for your damage. So you could go for a build with the knee bike knee pads, go all straight rats, for example, get your shield out and then just jump over things to reload. That will help as well. That will help you from stopping reloading if you are in battle. But if you are in a big battle and you need to reload and those stacks are up onto that 200%, you'll just kill yourself. So it's very, very situational if you play with the knee bike knee pads, in my opinion. So in my opinion, the best way to utilize the backfire SMG, the new exotic SMG, is to go for hazard protection and just get that bleed out of there. So go for your bleed resistance. But let's head over to the gameplay, guys, and I'm gonna show you some clips and show you what the backfire is capable of. Because if you run around enough and take out normal enemies, it can be quite nice in taking out the named. The buff of that 200% critical hit damage helps out a lot. But to be honest with you, I can't sit here and say go farm for this. And believe me, it takes some effort to scrap together because it's again very situational. Yes, it hits hard when it's procced. Yes, it's a lot of fun to play with it because it's something else. And yeah, that new gun just looks awesome. But in my opinion, we need to stack too much in stopping that bleeding. The Nia bike are even more situational in my opinion, so we need to stack into Hazard to stop, of course, taking ourselves out through that reload. And more often than not, I cleared the whole room before I could even go over that 100 stacks or even get close to it. Of course, you're stacking up quick when you're face to face with a biggie, but the damage takes too long in my opinion, versus the other close and personal, or yeah, the SMG builds, where your first 100 shots are already that 140, 150 critical hit damage. And again, guys, this is my opinion that you need to be close with an SMG build, or yeah, with the backfire build. And if you agree with me on this, there are other builds that utilize the risk of being close a lot more than when using this backfire build. But yeah, guys, that's pretty much it for the build and my opinion about the backfire itself. Yes, it's a lot of fun to play with. Yes, it hits very hard when it's procced. But again, I don't know if you want to invest in that much hazard protection or go over to the Nia bike knee pads. But I would love to know what you think about this new SMG and all the builds around it. But for today, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to smash that like button and hit that subscribers button. And of course, the notification bell. Pure Prime out.